Now, the official Suncoast weather with ABC 7 meteorologist John Scalzi.
Well, we're looking at an air temperature coming in already at 88 degrees, very close to the 90 degree mark. In some places, we've hit it 74. Our dew point is certainly a humid afternoon, as we would expect on the 4th of July. As we head into the later part of the afternoon and our temperatures climb into the lower 90s, that dew point value will combine with the air temperature to make it feel like, especially in inland areas, pretty close to the 100 degree mark. So by all means, stay hydrated. And if you're doing any strenuous outside activities, you know, give yourself a break now and then. 88 degrees in Wauchula, 89, almost 90 in Arcadia, 88 degrees in Myakka, 89 in Parrish, Lakewood Ranch. Bradenton comes in at 88 degrees. You got 90 in Venice, 88 degrees in Inglewood, Northport, 90 in Punta Gorda. And over here on Longboat Key, 87 degrees. Not much in the way of any kind of radar echoes currently, though I do suspect that will be changing over the course of the next few hours. Mostly east of the interstate is where we'll see the most likely beginnings of our showers. You can already see kind of the beginnings of a sea breeze front beginning to advance into our area from the other coast. That will, of course, be aided by a general southeasterly wind flow, and those rain showers that you see here will become more increasing in number in the southern tip of the state, eventually working their way into interior sections of Hardy, DeSoto, and also into Charlotte County as well. We'll develop that west coast sea breeze. That sea breeze will collide with that general southeasterly wind flow, and boom, we get our showers and thunderstorms, just as we have seen over the last several days. The wind flow is a little bit lighter today, I think, so we'll probably see a more intense sea breeze develop. Now, what that will simply do is keep most of the showery activity, I think, out in inland sections of the Sun Coast. We also have some slightly more stable air aloft, so the number of storms that we see will be limited today as well. This high pressure ridge really extends all the way across the center part of the state and out into Gulf waters. And the axis, the sort of the center of that high pressure ridge, is really right over the Sun Coast. And with that kind of a situation, it tends to lead to a more stable weather condition and some lighter, more variable winds. As far as the forecast for today goes, I bet you we could get some 1 inch, 1.5 inch rainfalls in inland areas today, but there'll be slow moving storms, and that's one of the reasons we'll get those kind of rainfall totals. They'll tend to lift off to the north and to the west, and generally speaking, die out as they get closer to shore. So the best rain chances will be inland. We'll have a very warm afternoon, as I mentioned, the feels like temperatures up close to that century mark, and a very slow moving storm system as well. Slow moving storms. The forecast for the beach again calls for that UV index to be warm, coming in at about a 12, 92 degrees at the beach. Watch that UV index. Boy, it won't take long for fair skinned folks to get a good burn going. So slather on the SPF 50 or better sunscreen. 85 degrees, the air temperature, I think, by this evening at around 9 o'clock under partly cloudy skies and just an isolated shower. Good boating weather, by the way. You'll have, generally speaking, a light chop out there. 20% chance of rain. That's it for today. Pretty nice little break there for a 4th of July. And then over the next several days, slowly increasing rain chances as we head into the weekend.